Oh, well, yeah, I do remember everything. I mean, in the end, everything happens really quickly. I had a quite good tow to the guy in front of me, and I wanted to overtake him going into Lisboa, so I kind of moved out of the tow. In the moment I moved out, he started braking, so because of that, I lost my two left side wheels.
As imagens que abrem esse vídeo são do acidente da piloto alemã Sophia Florsch no Grande Prêmio de Macau de 2018. Ela bateu a mais de 270 km por hora e precisou passar por uma cirurgia de mais de 11 horas em função de lesões na coluna. Sophia Florsch, it's really nice to have you here. You know, the Brazilian fans, they love motorsports, so it will be interesting to let them know you a bit better. I saw the video many times, but I want to hear it from you. What really happened?
Well, I mean, Macau is a really special track, and yeah, we had this normal race start, and of course there was a crash in the first corner, and or the second corner, I don't remember, after the score, I think. So we had safety car, which was all going fine, and then we had a restart, a safety car restart. And well, you know, in Macau, the tow, the slipstream is really important. And when you have a restart, everyone is close together. So I had a quite good tow to the guy in front of me, and I wanted to overtake him going into Lisboa. So I kind of moved out of the tow. But he, in the moment I moved out, he started braking. So because of that, I lost my two left side wheels. In the end, you know, yeah, well, I think no one really did a mistake there. At least the FIA said it right after the race that it was my mistake, and that it also wasn't chance mistake. It was just unlucky because yeah, one guy sitting in the corner pressed the button to put the lights off too much, so the yellow light was flashing. So if you looked in the right moment, or like everyone saw different moments, and for me there was no yellow flag. Chahan saw a yellow flag, so well, in the end it was just, let's say, unlucky. Which ended out good, because everyone is okay again, and everyone, yeah, managed to get out of that crash in the end good.
Do you remember the moments where you were flying, crashing? What was going through your mind at that moment?
Oh, well, yeah, I do remember everything. I mean, in the end, everything happens really quickly. It's normal, I think, as soon as you don't have any control over the car anymore, you just put your hands off the steering wheel. Every single race driver learns that pretty early already. So yeah, and then you just kind of wait for the car to stop, and that's also kind of what I did. But you don't really think about anything. I mean, it was happening all that quick, and then also when I landed, the marshals were there right away, and yeah, it's like the marshals, and when the doctors arrived, they did a really good job, and they followed what they had to do. In the end, I think because they did it that well, I'm still able to move everything, because it was really, really tight for me. But in the end, you know, they did a good job. Otherwise, I wouldn't be here like that now.
And it's nice to see that you were here, that you are in good health and still fast, still at the track. But I have to ask you, when you were there, after 11 hours of surgery, did you think about quitting motorsport?
Never. Mm-mm, never. I mean, never. I remember when I, on Sunday afternoon, when I arrived to the hospital, I was on that bench, and they pushed me to get the X-ray or the MRT, I don't remember. But I was on that bench, and they pushed me into the elevator. And before the elevator, there was a TV screen, and they just showed the F3 start again, because they restarted the race at that time. So I was like looking at it, and I was like, oh, I should have been there. So I've never expected that it takes that long, actually, and that I need a surgery, because I mean, of course, I had pain and everything, but for me, it wasn't that bad. And I also didn't know that the crash looked that bad. And for me, it was always clear to drive again. Yeah, 10 minutes later, I already wanted to get back into the car.
Good one. Thanks, Sophia. I hope you have an amazing season, and we will be here following all the action at the track. Thank you very much.
Bye-bye.